What you see in front of you is what we are going to create. As you can see, we can move the pawn forward. When we move the pawn to the other side of the board, we get a dialogue which lets us pick a piece to promote to, then the pawn will be transformed into that piece. If you want to know how to create this yourself, follow along. To get started, we are going to open up our source and then our referee. In our referee.ts, we can scroll down, and then at the bottom here we have an isValidMove function, and we also have our to-do list. So at the top of our to-do list we have our pawn promotion. What is pawn promotion? Pawn promotion is when a pawn moves to the other side of the board and then it gets the option to promote itself into a rook, a knight, a bishop or a queen. How are we going to create that? Well, to start off, we are going to check when the pawn is at the other side of the board. So, in other words, when a white pawn or a black pawn has reached the opposite side. For white, that will be the 7th row, and for black, that will be the 0th row. So the rows start from 0 at the bottom, 7 to the top. That's why white needs to go to the 7th row and black to the 0th row. Okay, but how do we know if a pawn has reached that row? When we let go of a pawn, we drop it at a row, or well, we drop it at an X and Y value. And to check which row it is, we only need to check the Y value. If we open up our chessboard.tsx, we can scroll up and here we will see our drop piece function. And this function will be executed when we drop a piece. So right here, we drop a piece and we also get an X and a Y position. So first we check if it is an en passant move. In this case, it won't be an en passant move. So we move on to the next statement. The next statement is if it is a valid move. Well, obviously it should be a valid move. So this is the place we need to start writing our code. Okay, so right here we loop through all the pieces. And then the current piece that we are handling is the piece. Here we check if the piece position is the same as the grab position. So what does this mean? In other words, is the piece the same piece that we have just grabbed? So for example, if we take this pawn and we drop it right here, then the same position for this pawn will be true. The next statement, else if, not same position, piece position and X and Y. That means if the piece was not the piece that we have grabbed. To demonstrate this to you, we are going to write a console log. And right here, we are going to say grabbed piece, like so. And then we can write our piece like so. And we want to add a plus to align it. And then right here, we say console.log not grabbed plus piece, and then we can close this off as well. And we want to move this out of the if piece type is pawn, because we want to run this even if it is not a pawn, like so. If we save this up and open up the console right here, we can maybe make it a little bit smaller because the page otherwise won't really fit. Yeah, so we'll do with this. If we refresh the page and move our piece and drop it right here, we see that we get, let's open up the console again, 26 times the not grabbed, 1 time the grabbed, and then 5 times the not grabbed. So what does this mean? This means that we have a total of 32 pieces, because we have 31 not grabbed pieces, 26 plus 5, and 1 grabbed piece, which results in a 32. Let's close the console. We see that we have a lot of pieces on the board. In a row, we have 8 pieces. We have 4 rows, and 4 times 8 is also 32, which means that we iterated over all the pieces, but only one piece was the grabbed piece, and that was this pawn. We open up the console again, and we see that the grabbed piece was object. Let's just remove the grabbed piece, or we can actually put this above here. And now, if we refresh the page and move a piece, we see that the grabbed piece now has an object, And this piece will say that it is on x2, y3. Let's look. 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3. So the grab piece was this pawn. Okay, so now we know the piece that we have just dropped, where we can find it in our code. The next thing we want to do is we want to check if that piece is on the 7th or 0th row, depending on if it's the black piece or the white piece. Okay, so we need to determine the team type of that piece. Alright, we are going to say let and then promotion row is equal to piece dot team type is equal to team type dot hour. Alright, so here we have a ternary operator which checks if the team of the piece is our team. If it is our team, then a promotion row should be the 7th row, because we are white, the 7th row is our promotion row. If it is not our piece, if it is the black piece, then the promotion row will be the 0th row. So behind the column we say 0. So we have 7 and 0. 7 for the white piece and 0 for the black piece. Alright. Next up, we want to check if the piece dot position dot y, we can also just say y, is equal to promotion row. Then we say this piece is up for promotion. Okay, let's refresh the page, open up our console, and move a pawn up. And we still have the not grabbed logging right here, so let's just remove that for now. We can refresh the page and move our piece to the other side of the board. Let's see, we have this piece is up for promotion. Great, that's true because our piece has reached the promotion row. Let's move the black piece as well, and the black piece also is up for promotion, and you see that we get a 2 because this is the second time that exactly this statement has been executed. Alright, so now that we know when a piece is up for promotion, we need to do something. We need to give the user the possibility to promote its pawn into one of the four types. The rook, the knight, the bishop, and the queen. We are going to do this with a model. And you might think like, what's a model? Well, a model is some kind of overlay for the screen, and it lets you show some information. And in this case, the model will show the available pieces in which we can transform our pawn. So right here, we create an empty object or an empty element. We move this all the way to the right, and then we create another div which has an ID of a pawn promotion model, like so. And then inside of here, let's say pawn promotion model. Let's save it up. And if we now refresh the page, we see that we have pawn promotion model on the top right here. Let's just select it so we can read it a little bit better. This is not what a model looks like. All right, this is just plain text. So in order to make it look like a model, we are going to make it a model. We are going to open up our chessboard.css. And we are going to target our pawn promotion model. We are going to give it a height of 300 pixels. I think that should be fine. I think that's a little bit too much. All right. Background color of purple. Let's see where we have our... Okay, so the thing that's happening right now is that the model is relative, or it's inside of the page, but we don't want it to be inside of the page. We want it to be on top of the page, because if it is inside the page, it's pushing the board away, and we don't want that. We want it to display itself over the board or on top of the board. So we add position absolute, like so. Great, now we get something a little bit better. We want to give it a fixed width as well, so let's say 800 pixels. Yeah, looks good. And then what we then want to do is we want to center it. So we say top of 50%, looks good, and then a left of 50%. And it looks also good, but now it's just moving out of the screen. So why is this happening? I mean, we center it, right? And that is true, since it does start at the center of the board. But the div is being rendered from the top left corner, which means that the middle of the screen is now the top left corner of this div. So in order for it, well, to put it actually inside of the middle of the screen, we need to subtract half the height and half the width from the top and the left. So we say calc 50% minus, and then 300 pixels divided by 2 is 150 pixels, like so. And then for the width, we have calc 50% minus 400 pixels, like so. And now we have our model exactly at the middle of the screen, which is great. Okay, so now that we have this, we actually want to present the user with some options. I'm going to give you a little hint. The options that we are going to present are the rook, the knight, the bishop, and the queen. And you can pause the video right now if you want to try to present those options in the model yourself. Okay, so in order to present the user with some options, we are going to open up our chessboard.tsx, and right here we are going to remove the text pawn promotion model, and we are going to insert an image, like so. And this first image will be the image of the rook. So it is source is equal to slash assets slash images slash rook, and then lowercase w.png. Let's save it up, and we should see a small rook appearing. Great. This is what we want. We can do the same for the other pieces. So the other pieces were the bishop, the knight, and the queen. We should see them appearing any second now. Exactly. Nice. So now we have our images appearing on screen. Great. We also want to style them a little bit. So first of all, let's remove the purple background and give it a see-through black color, which will be RGBA, and then an alpha of 0.2. That might be a little bit too see-through. 0.5, 0.8. 0.8 looks fine. Great. Next, we want to make the images a little bit bigger. So let's see right here. We want to select the images from the pawn promotion model. So we say hashtag pawn promotion model image. And then we give it a fixed height of 100 pixels, like so. And we might even want to make it bigger to 120 pixels, like so. All right, this looks good. And next we want to center them. So our pawn promotion model will have a display of flex. Nothing happened, but now we can use justify content space between. Space between looks good, but we can make it even better because now they are sticking to the sides. We can prevent it by using space around. It also calculates the sides. So next up we have align items center, and we're going to put this above here. And now our items are centered. Great. We are also going to add a little bit of a visual to it. We are going to say hashtag pawn promotion model image hover. And then when we hover over an image, we want the cursor pointer, like so. This looks great. And we want to have a background color of RGBA 255, 255, and then 255, and then 0.5. Like so. Looks good. But yeah, it's a rectangle. We want to make this a square. So what happens? No, that's not good. We want to keep it 0.3. That's better, I think. Then we want to give it a border radius because we want a circle. So right here, border radius 50%. And that's a big mistake for me. We shouldn't put this on the pawn promotion model, but on the image, like so. This looks better. And then also we want to give it a little bit padding. 20 pixels should be fine. Yeah. All right. So Now the user can select its piece that it wants to promote the pawn into, and we also get a nice indicator which piece is currently being selected. Great. However, we cannot yet click on them. That's the next thing that we are going to do. In our chessboard.tsx, we are going to add an onclick for the image. We are going to make an anonymous function, and here we want to execute a function when we click on the rook. What do we want to do when we click on the rook? Well, we want to promote the pawn. So let's make a function which says promote pawn. And for now, let's do it like this and say console.log promoting pawn exclamation mark. Let's save it up. And then we still need to define it right here. Promote pawn, like so. Let's save this up as well. And then if we open up our console, and if we click on the rook, we see that we get the message promoting pawn. If we click once more, we still get promoting pawn, and again, promoting pawns. We have promoted the pawn 11 times right now. So we want to do the same for the bishop, the knight, and the queen. Let's save this up. And now if we click on the bishop, we can also promote pawns, the knight as well, and for the queen as well. Great. But if we promote a pawn when we click on a rook, we want to promote it into a rook. If we click on a bishop, we want to promote it into a bishop. All right, so that's what we're going to do next. If you'd like to implement this yourself, you can pause the video right now. All right, so in order to promote a pawn into a rook when we click on the rook, we are going to give the piece type here. So piece type dot rook, right here piece type dot bishop, piece type dot knight, and piece type dot queen. And for now we will get red errors or red lines. That's because this doesn't expect a piece type at all, but now it does. So now, instead of just saying promoting pawn, we can say promoting pawn, let's make backticks out of this, into piece type, like so. If we save this up and click on the rook, we see promoting pawn into 3, promoting pawn into 1, promoting pawn into 2, and promoting pawn into 4. So you might think like, well, what are those numbers? If we go to our constants and look at the bishop, we see that it is a 1. That's right, because it's the 0-1 index for the piece type enum. The rook was a 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, which is the corresponding index number for the piece type. The same goes for the knight and the queen. That's why we get those numbers right there. All right, so now we have the promote pawn function. We know which piece type we want to promote it into, but we don't have a pawn to promote yet. So we need to create a pawn which we can promote. All right, so in order to keep track of a pawn that we want to promote, we need to set it. And if we want to set something, we are probably going to use state. So up here, we are going to create a new piece, const promotion pawn set promotion pawn equals use state. And then this will be a piece, like so. And what we can do then is down here, we can say, okay, if it is on a promotion row, let's say set promotion pawn to the current piece. All right, we can remove this. And then right here, when we click on the promote pawn, we want to say console.log promotion pawn. Promotion pawn. Yeah. Okay. So first of all, if we want to do this, we need to remove the dialog. And when we are eligible for a promotion, we want to show it again. Second of all, the dialog, when we show it, we don't want to interact with the pieces behind it, like I'm doing right now. This is not something that we want. If the dialog is open, the user shouldn't be able to do all this kind of stuff. So, we're going to work on that first. If you want to try this out yourself, you can pause the video right here. First things first, in order to make the background not clickable when we open the model, we are going to add a model body. So inside of our div right here, we add another div which says model body. And then our model body, let's see, we can move this up and then move this up as well. Let's save this up, and the whole starting will be wrong. Yeah, that's fine. But the model body will actually inherit everything from the model. So everything that we've put in here, we're going to put it inside of the model body. And then here, hashtag promotion model dot model body. We're going to put it like this. And then right here, we want to say dot model body. Now they are bigger. And then we need to do the same right here. So the hover effect still works. And it still works. Nice. But now we also have a palm promotion model. And if we inspect it and we go to our model right here. Oh, this is so not visible. Okay. I'm going to move this all the way to the right. Yeah. If we look inside of here, we see that we have an app. We have a palm promotion model and we have the model body. So the model body is the actual model. But this, the palm promotion model, this could be something which prevents us from pressing or clicking on the background. We are going to create an overlay, it's called, I think. And to create the overlay, we're going to say position absolute, top 0 pixels, right 0 pixels, bottom 0 pixels, and left 0 pixels. So I didn't press save yet. Let's pay attention to where this pawn promotion model is right now. Right now it is, we cannot even see it yet. It is somewhere on the page. If we look at the text at the top, it says 800 pixels wide by 0 pixels high. But nothing is highlighted. If we go, for example, over the model body, this one is highlighted. We don't see that for the pawn promotion model. So if we press save right now, just watch what happens. If we now go over the palm promotion model, we see that the whole screen is now the palm promotion model. Alright, so what does this mean? Can we still grab the pieces behind it? Well, yeah, we can. But now if we refresh the page, we cannot anymore. Okay, so that was just a little bug because we didn't refresh it. But what's happening right now is that the palm promotion model is preventing us from clicking on the background. And by setting the position to absolute and then the sides, the top, right, bottom, left to 0 pixels, it will just cover the whole screen. So this is great. Now we have prevented the user from moving any pieces when the model is open. Next up, we want to hide the model. In order to do that, we want to add another class to the palm promotion model. And let's call it hidden. Let's save it up. And right here, we can select it. And then we can say display none. And it's gone. It's gone. So right now what happens is if the class hidden is on it, the display will be none. If we remove the class hidden, let's just remove it from here, it will be displayed. So now we can actually toggle the model by adding and removing the hidden class. Okay, so if a pawn is on the other side of the board, we should be able to see the model, but we don't see it. So what do we need to do? We need to remove the hidden class. In order to do that, we also need to keep track of the element of the model. So right here we have our pawn promotion model. Let's give it a ref as well. And then we need to create a ref up here. So we have the chessboard ref, const model ref is equal to use ref HTML div element null. And then this model ref is going to be used down here. And then we can use that ref to to access the element. So right here we say model ref dot current dot class list dot remove hidden. So this lets us remove a class from the model ref. So if we go up, 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 diagonal, diagonal, we see that the model is now visible and we cannot click on the background anymore. So let's take a look at Inspector. We're going to open up the app and then the Palm production model, promotion model. We see the class hidden. What if we move this up, up, diagonal, and diagonal? The hidden should be gone. And as you see, the class is now removed from the model and the model is now visible. Great. All right, so now that we have that, we actually need to keep track of the promotion pawn. We wanted to make a state for it, which we have already did, I think. Yeah. And we have already created the logging for it in the promote pawn function. If we open up our console and then move a pawn to the other side of the board and then click on a rook, we get promoted pawn into 3 and we also get the promotion pawn. If we open up this promotion pawn, we see x1, y7, and that corresponds to the pawn that we have just dropped right there, which is great because now we actually have a reference to the promotion pawn. Now all that's left to do is we need to first of all remove the model. Second of all, we need to update the pawn to become selected type. So in this case the rook, otherwise the bishop, the knight or the queen, but in this case we would want it to be a rook. All right, so we can remove the login right here and we can say if we want to update all the pieces. All right, so we also do that up here. And in order to update the pieces, we need to loop through all the pieces and then update them one by one. So we say const updated pieces is equal to pieces.reduce. And then we have the pieces and a piece, I think. It's results and piece. Well, it's basically the same because the results is a list of pieces, but let's stick with the same name convention. We want to say that the result is right now a piece, but as you can see right there, result piece. We want to make it an array of pieces. So now if we hover over this, we see that we get an array of pieces. And then at the end of every reduce iteration, we say results.pushPiece. All right. And we also need to return the results at the end. So return results. Those are the two steps we need to do. And what we also need to do is we need to check if the current piece that we are updating is the promotion piece. So we can say if same position piece that position and then promotion pawn that position. If it is in the same position, then we want to update it. That's basically it. We want to update it. First of all, we get an error here because the position might be undefined. Well, that's fine because we can just say if promotion pawn is equal to undefined return, and then we can remove the question mark right here. Great. One thing, if the promotion pawn is undefined, the model will always be visible, but it should never be undefined, so we might still need to fix that later. But for now, we can go with this, and now we want to update the piece. So we say piece.type is equal to piece type. All right, now it has updated this piece, and we need to set the state again. So we say set pieces to update the pieces. Let's save this up. And what if we press on the rook? Well, I think nothing will happen because we still need to add the hidden class to the model. All right. So we had the model ref dot current dot class list dot add and then hidden like so. Let's save it up. And if we now press on the rook, the pawn is still a pawn, but watch what happens. If we move down, we take it. If we move down, it moves down. If we move to the right, it moves to the right. If we move up, it moves up. Can we still hit like a pawn? No, we cannot, because it's actually a rook. It is actually a rook what we have created, but the image is still of a pawn. Well, in order to fix that, we need to also update the image. Otherwise, this pawn will just live on as a pawn, and well, that can also be fine, but it will be more clear if the image was also updated. So we say piece.image is equal to, and then we need to know which team the piece is, because we need to update the white piece with a white rook and the black piece with the black rook. So we say const team type is equal to piece.team is equal to team type.hour. If it is, then it is white, otherwise it's black. Okay, so we have another ternary operator, and we check if the piece is on our team. Then we say, okay, team type is W, otherwise team type is B. All right. Then we want to set the image to assets/images/. Then we want to set the piece type. So we need to make a switch statement for the enum. So for now, let's say rook, lowercase, and then team type, and then dot png. But this rook might be something else, because right now, if we move to the end and promote it to a rook, well, that's fine, because we, as you can see, we move it to a rook. Oh, and one more thing that's happening is it's also triggering on other pieces than a pawn. We only want to execute this when the piece is a pawn. So yeah, we still need to fix that, but that should be fine. If we move up and we move it into something else, for example, the bishop, we still get a rook. So we need to remove this hard-coded rook, and we need to replace, where were we? Here. And we need to replace it with the piece type is equal to, and then empty. And right here, we add piece type as well. Well, maybe not piece type, maybe just piece. No, that's also, what should we call it? Image is fine. And then we say switch piece type case piece type dot rook. If it is a rook, the image will be image is equal to rook, and then we can break this off, and it doesn't like that because image is a constant. We need to make it a let, because a constant can only be assigned once, and a let can be reassigned. So now we have the rook, the bishop as well. And now we have the rest as well. So if we save this up and move another pawn to the other side of the board and translate or promote this into a queen, we get a queen. Great. What if we do this with the enemy pawn? Do we still get this? Yes. And we get the rook and we get the black rook. Nice. Okay, so great. This works. Only thing we need to fix is one, we need to prevent the pawn from re-promoting. So if we move the horse here or the knight, we can re-promote it. Well, that's not something that we want. Only a pawn should be able to promote. And second of all, if we open a dialogue with the black piece, we should get black pieces right here. I think that looks a little bit better styling wise. Otherwise, you might think like, hey, why do I get to pick a white piece if I'm the black team? That might be confusing. So for the first thing, which is only promoting pawns and not other pieces, you can try that out yourself. You can pause the video right now. The solution is actually really simple. If we go up here and go to this line or this rule, we see that we check if the Y position is on the promotion row, but we don't check if the piece is a pawn. So we need to say and piece.type, not team, type, is equal to piece type.pawn. Let's save this up, refresh the page, and right now we shouldn't be able to reassign it. So we make a queen and we cannot reassign it. Great. So that's fixed. The last thing we need to do is we want to make the black promotion model display black pieces. All right, so in order to do that, we need to modify this image source right here with the W. We need to make it a B or W depending on the current promotion piece or promotion pawn. We're going to create a function for this. We are going to put it under here. We're going to say function promotion team. Is that the correct name? Promotion team type is a function, and this returns promotion pawn dot team is equal to team type dot hour. So we check, okay, if it is our pawn, then we want to make it white, so we say W. If it is the enemy pawn, we want to make it black, so we say B. Then we can use this method or this function inside of here. Let's replace the how do you call it, the quotation marks with backticks, so we can use string interpolation. And then right here we can replace this with promotion team type, and it's a function, so we just need to add the parentheses. And oh, that actually was pretty impressive. It just refreshed out of itself. Let's do the same for the bishop. So right here we're going to put this, and instead of rook we say bishop. Let's save it up. Does it? Yeah, it refreshes. Nice. That looks pretty cool. And then the same for the rook. No, not the rook, the knight. And then last but not least, our queen, probably the most chosen one because it's the piece which can do the most moves. Now we have the black pieces in the model, which is great. Let's check if we still have the white pieces in this model. We do. Awesome. One last thing we are going to do is we are going to change the color of the model. So we're going to set this to 127. Let's refresh the page and promote a white pawn. Does it still look okay? Yeah, it looks doable. But the main thing is that the black pieces are better visible right now, because before they weren't, because, well, the background color was also pretty dark. So now it's more visible and better to read. All right, so I think we nailed it. We added a pawn promotion. We can promote it into four different types: the rook, the knight, the bishop, and the queen. And I think it's awesome. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you could follow along. Leave a like, comment down below, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye!